Hi, welcome to the next episode in the series called From Zero to Pentesting Hero. My name is Kacper Szurek, and today we are going to search for some vulnerabilities in the code responsible for XML parsing. Here is the example Java code. It retrieves the content of the file and then parses it using Document Builder. In the last line, we get the document's root element and display it. What does the input file have inside? It starts with the XML declaration and then the version attribute, which is required here. If we do not provide a version, the file cannot be processed and we will get an error message. Next, the test root element is defined with the sample value demo. So if our code example works properly, we should see a demo string on the screen. The XML standard, however, is much more developed. One of the additional functionalities is the ability to create entities. They are similar to macros, for example, from C language. In short, we can define a template with long content. Instead of pasting the same content in each document, just use the entity. Parser will automatically find all entities and replace them with this long string of the data we define. Let's see an example. Entities are created using the keyword doc type and entity. In my case, the newly created entity is called replace. Its value is very long text. Now, in the root element, I refer to the entity using the ampersand and the semicolon. When we run the parser, we can see that our entity has been replaced with the predefined text. So, where is today's vulnerability? The creators of XML had an idea that it will be nice to have entities defined in external files. Thanks to this, long strings of text will not disturb the readability of XML files. The keyword system lets us enable this functionality. Next, we give the name of the file that contains the content of the entity. And here lies the core of the problem. As you can expect, the attacker can provide here any path that he likes. In my case, there is a secret file with secret content. I create XXE entity, which will read the contents of this file. Now, when we look at the result, we can see the content of this secret file coming from the server on which the application is launched. This attack is called XML external entity. So how do you protect yourself from it? One of the solutions may be launching a special mode, secure processing, which is disabled by default. Now, we will get an error message when we try to attack. And that's all I wanted to show in today's episode. As you can see, parsing XML files can be complicated. Perhaps this is why the JSON format is getting more and more popular. If you like this material, feel free to comment, give a thumb up, and subscribe to this channel. See you in the next episode. Bye!